Welcome. It's good to see you. And what a privilege it is to get a chance to talk to you again. Linda and I had announced our retirement, and there was a lot of questions came up out of that. So I wanted to take a minute and just answer the questions that I've heard. If you have more, let us know. Put them in the things in the question below. First of all, thank you for all the best wishes. I was totally unexpecting that. I just was telling people what I'm doing. And the number of phone calls, texts, and the comments on Facebook, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And your encouragement is just enjoyable. Now, I did want to answer some of the questions. One of the questions, Mike, was, are we going to close the church, or who are they going to send? What's going to happen now? Mm-hmm. And I'd like to answer to the people who have been asking that question, mm-hmm. What happens here now that I'm retiring? I would like to introduce to you my boss, superintendent of the South Florida Conference, and he has about 60 churches, and his job and his team's job is to find the appropriate pastor that matches the personality and the mission of the church. And so there's not going to be a hiccup here. They're not going to close the doors. He's going to talk to the Lord. We let the Lord stay in charge of his church. And he's going to, from his contacts and stuff, he's going to find the appropriate pastor who will come and love you. We've built a great relationship, but I'm telling you, the next pastor will love you just as much as I did. And everything will go ahead. So, Mike, could you tell us a little bit about that process of transitioning?
Happily. So, welcome, everybody. My name is Mike McAvoy, and I am the superintendent of the Southeast Region Conference for the Free Methodist Church. And one of the beauties, I didn't grow up a Christian, and I didn't grow up in the church, and I didn't grow up in the Free Methodist faith tribe. So, one of the beauties that I've come to appreciate about all of this is that whatever we're going through, we're not alone. So you're a local church and you're a family, but you belong to a larger family. And so the beauty in this situation is that Cape Coral Community Church, the Rigbys, are not going through this alone. And we do, as the Free Methodist Church, have a process in place on how we transition leadership. And so to explain that to you very quickly, is that first and foremost, we recognize that this is not a democracy. None of us gets a vote per se, and that we're really leaning more into a prayerful discernment. And there will be leadership identified from the local church. There is a team that is a part of the conference level. And together we will work, we will pray, we will discern, and we will process those folks that are called by God to serve in leadership. And mm-hmm. as Pastor mm-hmm. David mentioned, you know, to really perfectly discern who is the fit, who is it that matches the purpose, the vision, the mission, the values, the culture, the DNA of this particular local body, its particular niche in mm-hmm. the community, and the call that God has on that church family to reach the community and beyond.
Yes. Yeah.
So that is the super, super condensed version of how this will work, but my first step obviously will be to connect with what is the local church delegate and the board, and we will process forward in that journey together. And it's my privilege and something that honestly I'm excited about. I really do truly believe what Pastor David said, that Jesus is going to build his church mm-hmm. and that he's in charge. And
yes.
I truly believe that God has a plan and a future for Cape Coral Community Church. So I'm looking forward to meeting many of you and seeing what it is that God has in store.
Beauty. If I could just back up, when you say this is not a democracy, you have to remember we've brought some part of civic government into the body of Christ. The church is both a civic organization with the government, but it is also a theocratic organization with God. Yes. So when he says the election of a pastor, the appointment of a pastor, that is a God thing. Mm-hmm. And that is when you fall on the rules of theocracy, mm-hmm. not democracy.
Right.
And so that's why we have leaders.
Yeah.
And we trust them, and I trust you. I'm so excited that this has fallen on your lap. And Not mine. And so we're glad to have you, and I've got the greatest confidence in you and the team. And so thank you for coming down and giving us a few minutes and explaining the process. So we appreciate it.
My privilege.
And we're praying for you.
Thank you. God bless.